kind of power. So, how do you reconcile evolution and the theory with the reason?
Let me just say one or two things, because often people regard evolution as a venture or atheism. But the first thing to state is what exactly do you mean by evolution? Because there are these five methods in the world as I understand it. I'm not a biologist, but I do read a lot of biology, and I can some kind of biology. Because I meet people that say this. So let me say one or two things. We need to begin. I'm sure. We're dealing with life and two things about life. Its existence and its variation. And Richard Dawkins did a very famous book for time, which I found. The right book is the natural selection, the God automatic mechanism that Darwin discovered, is the explanation for life and the existence of variation. Half of that statement is absolutely false, and Dawkins admitted it, but only after many years. Let's give it straight once and for all. Evolution, whatever it does or doesn't impair its existence of life. And the reason is obvious. Evolution depends on the existence of life to do anything. So it can't explain the existence of life. So the problem with the origin of life remains scientifically even harder than it did in 1953 for a man hearing the Nobel Prize because they claimed to have solved the origin of life by producing a fluorescence for several other tests. So we've got to separate those two things because they're crucially important. Now, it's quite obvious that natural selection explains something. Just look at it because they're widely not look the same. Because they've been selected, and I think there is some selected rule of the night, because of the biology. I want to look at that. And mutation has done something. I think it's about a third of us suffer from a mutation of a chronic illness of the young. So it's pretty clear that what Darwin observed, the European observed, particularly the studies of the world's a big place, and you can get variations because of isolation, all this kind of stuff. So, natural selection, mutation, clearly does something. And I can accept that because you can see what's happening. There is a more difficult question, and it would take me a long time to grapple with this, because listening to some of the leading biologists in the world, I see them asking questions about whether it does anything. That is in terms of variation. There's nothing in terms of existence. So the first thing we need to get absolutely clear is evolution has a pattern of existence of life. And the origin of life is not quite dependent, but the origin of information is part of it. And that has to be done because that interest me as a mathematician. I have developed quite a lot of argument about that. I'm going to see this in advertising on the internet in Canada, for example, papers, that's very good. But I'm going to the arguments and the theory of information which lead me to believe that the origin of life must have come from the mind. It's a question not of a mind of the dead. That's very important. Do you look up there and see these words? And postulate a mind behind them. It's not a mind of the gaps. It's the only explanation that's